Hello friends, in today's lecture we will study SIC and GAN devices, or I can say semiconductor devices, SIC and GAN semiconductor devices. So till now we have seen that all the semiconductor devices are made up of silicon, and silicon is have a monopoly in a market for every power semiconductor devices. In last decades, the research has been initiated for other semiconductor devices in order to reduce some merit, demerits or drawbacks which are present in silicon. Okay, so on that context, these two devices has been invented, SIC and GAN. There are several more, but these are important devices and they have proved themselves as a proper or as a best replacement for silicon. Yet they can't completely replace silicon because of the availability, then manufacturing, the reliability and cost. These are some big concerns. But if we overcome those concerns, then absolutely these devices are far better than the silicon. Okay, so we'll start with the SIC. So what is SIC? SIC is a compound of silicon and carbon. Okay, this is a compound of silicon and carbon mixed in 1:1 ratio. Okay, mixed into 1:1 ratio. Okay, so you people have only introduction to these devices, SIC and GAN. Now try to understand SIC is a material, semiconductor material. Similarly, GAN is a material. Okay, by using SIC, you can form transistor, diode, MOSFET, whatever. Similarly, by using GAN, means generally what we see, transistor has three layers, NPN. So NPN, all these layers are of a silicon. So instead that, we can use this material to increase its some good merits. Okay, so these are the materials. So don't expect that I will draw any structure, or you can form MOSFET, that BJT or anything using SIC or GAN. So you people have only introduction to this material, right? So as now just I said, SIC is a silicon and carbon mixed in 1:1 ratio. Now there are four major advantages of SIC over the silicon. Okay, first is it has less power loss. Second, it has high speed switching operation. Then it operate at high temperature and it has good heat dissipation characteristics. Okay, so we'll study one by one. First is a high power loss. Now, as I said, the big concern in semiconductor devices is of a power loss. Okay, so what silicon carbide has advantages? It has 10 times good breakdown strength than silicon. Are you getting? So its breakdown strength is 10 times greater than the silicon. So obviously, with small size of SIC device, you can achieve same breakdown strength as a some large size silicon device is giving. Okay, one more thing is the drift layer. So you know, no, drift layer means N minus layer. Okay, generally we have seen that in any device, if there is a N plus layer, above N plus there is a N minus layer, and I used to call it as a drift layer. Okay, so that drift layer. Now drift layer has around 1/10 width in SiC as of silicon. Okay, so if there is a particular MOSFET device, and if this is the width of drift layer, so with the silicon device, silicon. Now, if we are using SiC, then it will reduce to almost 1/10, means like this. In mean, so whole device will be in this size instead some huge size like this. Are you getting? So this reduces size, and obviously a large reduction in power loss. Are you getting? Okay, because if breakdown strength is higher, so small device can be used, and then drift layer is also 1/10 of that of silicon. And one more thing is, it has a very less conduction and switching loss. Okay, it has less conduction and switching loss. This is the first advantage. Second is, by using SiC, you can achieve high speed switching operation. Okay, by using SiC, you can achieve a high speed switching operation. Then third is operation at high temperature. So generally what happens, if this is a conduction band, this is valence band. So when temperature increases, this electrons move to the conduction band here, and it form a leakage current. Are you getting? It form a leakage current, which ultimately results in malfunction or abnormal operation of device. Are you getting? But for silicon, the band gap for silicon is 1.1 eV, electric volt, electron volt. For silicon it is 1.1 eV, and for SiC it is almost 3.3 eV. Are getting? Hence, SiC and GaN both are high band gap devices. Both are high band gap devices. So they are also called as a wide gap semiconductors. These devices are also called as a wide gap semiconductor. So in the case of SiC, this band gap is almost 3 times or that of for silicon. Okay. This is conduction. This is conduction. This is valence. And this is the band gap. So when SiC, this is for SiC device. So obviously leakage current will not be there, as there will not be any leakage current. So there will not be any temperature increase and abnormal operation. Here leakage, due to leakage current, temperature increases and abnormal operation happens. Okay. Then fourth advantage is, heat dissipation characteristics. Now SiC devices has almost 3 times the conductivity of silicon. Okay, so if this is a silicon, here there is a heat, and heat dissipation is also, I'm sorry, heat dissipation, this is a silicon. Heat dissipation should be happen so that heat get dissipated and device get cooler. But in SiC, it is almost 3 times, so it get dissipated very fast. Are you getting? Hence, I sort of said now it has a less conduction loss because it has a high conductivity. This material have high conductivity, almost 3 times. Hence, heat easily get dissipated. So these are some characteristics of SiC devices, and hence nowadays we have started using SiC devices more in a semiconductor. But as I said, due to availability and manufacturing, it can't completely replace silicon. Now next is a GaN devices. GaN device. Now what is GaN device? GaN device is a gallium nitride device. GaN, gallium nitride device. Okay. The main advantage of it is, as I said, it is a wide gap semiconductor. Both SiC and this GaN, these are wide gap semiconductor. It has band gap of almost 3.4 eV, means even higher than your SiC. SiC has 3.3 and this GaN has 3.4. okay, the main advantage of this is high efficiency, high reliability. Okay, so in these things, due to this particular advantage, efficiency, reliability, generally we use GaN in some power electronics or some microwave frequencies or some 5G base stations where switching, high switching is required. 5G base stations. Okay, so it has a high voltage and high temperature reliable operation due to its wide band gap. Due to wide gap band gap, it has high voltage and high temperature operation. Okay, so it is reliable. It has higher electron mobility compared to silicon. Its electron mobility is higher compared to silicon. It has low on resistance, hence obviously on state loss is less. Its breakdown threshold as same as that SiC. Its breakdown threshold is 10 times that of silicon. Okay, so obviously size will reduce. I have told you in SiC breakdown threshold is high, so that size will be reduced, and it has high switching frequency. High switching frequency. Okay, so this is some basic about your GaN devices and SiC devices. Okay, so you may in examination they may ask a 5-mark note on this particular devices, and the content which we have covered is enough. Now as these are some new devices and developed in last decade, you will not get much content on this on a book, so better you search for internet, or I will provide some videos. Okay, and as I said, though these devices are good, they can't completely replace the silicon due to its production cost. Okay, now all the devices has been covered. Now let's see comparison of the power devices. Comparison of power devices. Okay, so we'll see parameter, then how it is for BJT. SCR we have not covered, we'll see SCR later. BJT for MOSFET, how it is, and for I will even cover for SCR. Okay, don't worry, SCR is the same device like BJT, MOSFET and IGBT. That device I am going to cover later, but we can see property, no any issue. Okay, it's very easy. So what about symbol? BJT, you know its symbol is very simple, like this or like this. This is the symbol of BJT. What is the symbol for MOSFET? It is two types, no, N channel and P channel. Like this or else this. Okay, gate, source, drain. This is drain, this is source, this is gate. This is the symbol of MOSFET. What is the symbol of IGBT? It is same like a BJT, only thing is gate is insulated like this, right? Collector, emitter and gate. In BJT there is a base. This is IGBT, and the symbol of SCR is same like diode, only thing they have a gate terminal. Okay, remaining thing is same like a diode, anode, cathode. There is a gate terminal. We will see how it works later. Okay. Now, types of carrier in this device. The BJT is bipolar device. BJT is bipolar device. Bipolar means both majority and minority carrier conduct current. MOSFET is majority carrier device. Okay, IGBT is minority carrier device, and SCR is again majority carrier device. Are you getting? Okay, now we'll see what is the control for base. For BJT it has full control. Full control means what? It continuously require a base current. If you remove the base current, it will get turn off. Okay, MOSFET, again in MOSFET it has a gate has full control. Here I can say base has full control. MOSFET, BJT in MOSFET, gate has full control. Yes, right. And in IGBT also gate has full control, and SCR is a different thing. Okay, once SCR is turned on, then gate loses its control. Gate is required to turn it on, but when it turn on, then gate loses its control. So I can say gate has no control once turn on, right? Then on step drop. On state drop for BJT, its on state drop is less than 2 volt. On state drop means when conducting. MOSFET it is 4 to 6 volt. IGBT is around 3.3 volt, and for SCR it is less than 2 volt. Okay, this is a on state drop. Important point, that is a switching frequency. BJT has switching frequency of 10 kilohertz. Okay, MOSFET has higher up to 100 kilohertz. IGBT somewhat lower, that is 20 kilohertz, and SCR has around 500 hertz. So you can see that the MOSFET has highest switching frequency. Okay, now what drive the gate? What drive the gate? In BJT, you know, current drive the gate. In MOSFET, it is a voltage control device. IGBT also voltage control device. SCR is again current control device. Okay, then some another point, temperature coefficient. BJT is a negative temperature coefficient. Okay, MOSFET is a positive temperature coefficient. IGBT generally flat, or I can say positive. SCR negative. Okay, then voltage and current rating. BJT has 2 kilovolt to 1 kiloampere voltage current rating, MOSFET 1 kilovolt 50 ampere rating, IGBT 1.5 kilovolt 400 ampere rating, and SCR 10 kilovolt maximum and 4 kiloampere rating. Okay, then applications. BJT in DC to AC converters, induction motor, UPS, SMPS, choppers. What is chopper? We'll see later, don't worry. MOSFET, again DC chopper, low power UPS, SMPS, BLDC, brushless DC motor. Okay, IGBT, it is DC to AC converter, AC motor drives, then UPS, then choppers and SMPS. Similarly, what again? SCR. SCR is AC to DC converter, AC voltage controller. Okay, some electronics circuit breaker. Okay, so you don't understand what a chopper converter, we'll see it later. Okay, so this is how the basic comparison of all the devices. With this, we'll stop here. Thank you.